What is up, guys, and welcome back. So now in this video, we'll be working up with the checkout tab. So let's go ahead, and you can see that it says enable the use of coupons. I don't think so if I should explain you this, okay? You guys should already know that we can create coupons and then we can give some discount so that people can add coupon and then apply it, and this will be automatically applied here, okay? So then we have calculate coupon discounts sequentially. When applying multiple coupons, apply the first coupon to the full price and the second coupon to the discounted price and so on. So this means that you can run two promotions at once, like 50% off, the other one is 50% off more. So if someone has got two coupons, then he can apply two coupons both. Like he will enter 50% off, the 50% off will be applied, and then he will add that another coupon, and that coupon will also be applied. So then I don't think so if you want to run this. So make sure that you do not add it. Okay, you do not check this, because only one coupon can be used per order. Okay, and then we have enabled the guest checkout. This means that when anyone wants to check out, then he don't have to be registered, okay? So this means that you, if you want them to just enter the address and then check them out, and then you can, or they have to create an account to your site, and this is important. So you can just uncheck this, and the account creation will be compulsory. Then we have the forced secure checkout. This means that you need to get an SSL certificate. You can just read about it. This is that you have to buy, and how this is basically this, like HTTPS, and this is green secure. So you can basically get the SSL certificate, and then you can apply to your site. I'm going to show you how can you get it for free when we will be moving on forward. Okay, so let's go down, and we have the cart page, we have the checkout page, and then we have the terms and conditions. Okay, so you can create a page for terms and conditions, then you can add that. So let's just go ahead, let's just create a new page. Okay, let's add the terms and conditions, and let's just assign that. So I'm gonna add terms and conditions. Okay, and then here I'm gonna add some of my terms. So here would be condition one, here would be condition two, here would be condition three, and something like that. So I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna hit publish right now. Okay, and then I'm gonna come here, I'm gonna refresh this page right now, and then I'm gonna select the page from the terms and conditions. So you can see that on the order page, if I just come here and I just refresh it, okay, and then I go to this right here, I just click proceed to checkout. Okay, and then you can see that here would be the terms and conditions, and if I click here, C1, C2, and C3 is coming. So this basically refers to this. Okay, so now let's go down, and we have the pay. So this is like the URL, that how you want the URL to be for order pay, for order received, for add payment method, for delete payment method, for set default payment method. So leave this as it is. Do not worry about it. And then we have the payment gateways. Okay, so first of all, we have the check payments, and that is enabled. So if I just come here to the checkout, you can see that I have only one option. It is saying please send a check to store name, store street, store town, and country, and store postcode. Okay, so same like this, we want to come here to the direct bank transfer, and I'm going to add the account name. So I'm going to be entering my account name. Here would be the my account number. Okay, and then instead of the account number, I want to add the bank name. So that is going to be HPL. Okay, and I'm going to add the sort code, so it can be anything. And then I want to add the IBAN, that is the international bank account number, and then the BIC SWIFT. So you can add anything here. And then let's go ahead and let's hit add account. So you can see this has been added. So let's just go ahead. I just deleted my account by mistake. So I'm going to add this again. Add the sort code, the IBAN. And let's hit save. So you also want to check this because we want to enable the bank transfer. Make your payment directly into our bank account. Please use your order ID as the payment reference. Your order will not be shipped until the funds have cleared in our account. So I'm going to hit save changes. And you can see this is right here. So the bank transfer is right here. If I just come here and I just hit this, you can see then here will be a new option, and this says direct bank transfer. So if someone clicks here, this is the description that is coming. And when he will just place the order, we will then give him the bank account details, not right now. Okay, so same like this, we have the check payments, and then we have the cash on delivery, if you want to enable the cash on delivery. And the last we have is the PayPal. So you can just work with the PayPal. Okay, how it's gonna work, you can just click PayPal standard, and then you can come here, you can enter your PayPal title. This will be the description, and this will be the email address. So if I wanna enter this address, okay, and then I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna hit save changes right now. You don't have to work on it right now. There we go. If I just come here right now, and then I have to come here, and then I refresh this, you're gonna see a new thing, and that will say PayPal. So what is PayPal? If I just click here, you can see pay by PayPal. You can pay with our credit card, your credit card, if you don't have a PayPal account. Okay, so this is the payment gateway, basically, where you have to sign up with your credit card, and then you can receive payments if you want to run e-commerce site. So this is really very important. Okay, so then when everything is done, you can send, receive payments from with PayPal. I'm also going to show you that how can you create test payments with the sandbox account. Not right now, but later on when we will add a lot of products, and then we will be working up with the payment methods. Okay, so I'll also show you that how can you add a specific payment gateway to your account, and also you can accept credit cards. So now we're done with this right now. Okay, we have the receiver email address, we have the invoice prefix, and then we have shipping details and everything right here. So now we're totally done with this. In the next video, we will be working up with the accounts, and then we will just finish everything right here. And then we'll be working up with the products. We'll add some more products. We'll discuss different type of products, and then we'll end that. And then we will build a professional e-commerce based website. So stay tuned, guys, and bye-bye.